Okay, to the dining hall we go. I found myself in surprisingly high spirits and hurried to the dining hall. But when I found out what was waiting for me there... Did they already find it? No trouble found? Is this it? What happened to the others? What happened to the others? Aren't they coming? There was only three people in the dining hall. Sakura, Hina, and Kyoko. So, including me, only four people? God, this is why I hate people who take their sweet time with everything.
However...
Anyway, let's wait a little longer for the others. Nah. Okay. So we decided to wait in case anyone else showed up. But no matter how long we waited, still all just four of us? So, it's 8 o'clock. We've been waiting for a full hour. Why haven't the others come? Here and Celeste have never missed a day till now. And what I'm really worried about is Hifumi and Taka. They were more eager than anyone to look for alter ego, and they're not here.
It can't be.
Something must have happened. Huh?
It would seem...
I was careless. I was too distracted by alter ego, but Monokuma gave us a motive. There was no way something wouldn't happen eventually. Monokuma's motive?
$10 million! I've prepared this graduation present for whichever lucky student makes it out of here alive!
Damn it, that might be a possible connection as well.
What do you think? It's $10 million! $10 million smackaroos! It's like totally wowy wow wow, am I right?
What are you, wow wow Bubsy? Wow wow Wubsy, not Bubsy. Who's Bubsy again? Oh, the shitty, yeah, oh, whatever. Don't tell me someone did something for money. That's what I wanted to say, but I didn't bother. I already understood. I understood, and I hated that I did. You can never really know another person completely. Anything can happen here, and you can't consider it strange. Not really.
Hey.
We need to go look for the people who never showed up.
Hmm.
Okay, let's go track them down. Without another word, we left the dining hall.
Hey.
We can cover more ground if we split up. Sakura, you can go check the dorms. Make sure to check all of our rooms. Makoto, you check the first floor of the school. Meanwhile, I'll check the second floor.
Okay,
then I'll guess I'll check the third floor.
Anyway.
Don't take any risks. If anything happens, call for help right away.
But...
I really hope nothing happens. So do I.
Well, then.
Okay, let's go. Anxiety was written across each of our faces as we went our separate ways. Without hesitating, I rushed to the first floor of the school. So, when someone dies, that means as long as three people have searched for the dead body, then there will be an announcement, correct? So, no one has searched for that dead body just yet. At least. Alright, let's look at the classroom first. Is there anything unusual about the classroom? This blackboard belongs to us now. Secret beauty. There's nothing. No one here. Alright. Okay, so room 1A. Nothing. This room? Alright, okay, so that's the quarter house room. Can't go there just yet. What other room have we not cleared yet? What's this called? The AV room. Alright. The audio-visual room. Could anyone be inside here? There's no one here from what I'm seeing so far. Alright. So far, so good. What? That was Hina! She's supposed to be checking! The third floor! There was no time to think, I was running- okay. I flew upstairs leading to the third floor. Right away, I saw her standing in the hallway.
Please!
Makoto! Hina, what's wrong? It's awful! The rec room door was open, and when I looked inside, I saw... What'd you see? I better get the others, right? I'm gonna go get them. You go on ahead, Makoto! Before I could say anything, she was rushing downstairs. The rec room? What did she see in there? By this point, I was used to acting without thinking, so without thinking, I leap into the rec room. The first thing I saw when I got to the rec room was...
Ugh.
It was Celeste, and she was hurt. Okay, no one's murdered at least, but goddamn, what happened here? Makoto! Celeste, what happened? Are you stupid? I got attacked. Attacked? By who? I'm not sure. Some sort of strange man. A strange man? A suspicious person whose existence is so unusual. I can't help but call him strange. Without a doubt, it was some sort of strange, suspicious individual. And that man attacked me with the hammer on the ground there. Really? Is it one of us? Is that a strange man, then? What is this? It's some kind of wooden hammer or something? Pretty strange device. There's some writing on it. Justice Hammer 1? That was the hammer he attacked me with. I barely managed to avoid the blow, but I stumbled upon and fell. I'm now cursed by my lack of daily exercise. So, you were attacked with this? Justice 1 Hammer 1. Makoto? Celeste?
Okay.
I found Sakura. Celeste, what on earth happened here? Apparently she was attacked by some kind of strange man. A strange man? Tell us everything you can remember, Celeste. Be as detailed as you can. Well, it all happened earlier this morning. I woke up a little bit 7 a.m. Nighttime was not yet over. But I knew it was about to end, so I decided that it would be okay if I decided to take a little stroll around the first floor. I understand now that that was a mistake. Anyway, that was where I first saw the strange man. I was immediately wary of him. He was obviously suspicious, so I had decided to follow after him in secret. As I followed, I saw him go into the rec room. I tried to peek through the gap to the door, which is when he noticed me and... And that's when you were attacked. It happened after 7 a.m., just after nighttime had ended. So, if it happened just after 7 o'clock, then that was just about an hour ago, right when we were all meeting up in the dining hall. The attack caused me to lose consciousness, which would mean I was unconscious about for an hour.
But...
Well, I'm glad you weren't hurt too badly. That was because I begged and groveled for my life. You did?
As for me...
I told him I would do anything if he spared me. I offered to lick his boots, whatever it took.
I see.
So you were willing to throw away all your pride.
Indeed.
It is a necessary skill for survival. Anyway, the important thing now is that we go search for the suspicious individual. If we do not hurry, this could become a serious problem. Celeste, what do you mean by a serious problem? When I looked in the rec room, I saw that the suspicious man was not alone. He had with him Ifumi. Ifumi? After he attacked me, he dragged Ifumi away.
What?
You mean Ifumi was kidnapped?
Shouldn't
we start looking for him then? Listen, Celeste, did anything in particular stand out about this strange guy? Did anything stand out? Well, rather than trying to explain it, it would probably be faster if I simply showed you. Showed
Indeed.
Us? This is Hifumi's hand-me-down, his digital camera. You don't mean...
Actually...
I was able to photograph the suspicious individual without him realizing it. Seriously? Let's see it! I would tell you not to be shocked, but I fear it would do you no good. With a strange comment in mind, we all looked at the camera. What the fuck?! Huh? What?! Well, you were definitely right about the strange part. Their face is totally covered. Is that a robot costume? As I said before, a very strange and suspicious individual, yes? So this weird robot guy dragged Ifumi away? And I took this right after being attacked. In other words, a full hour ago. Which is why, if we don't hurry, it could become a serious problem.
I see.
I believe I understand what happened. Well, no. There's not much I don't understand, but... The point is, someone dressed like that dragged Ifumi away. And it happened over an hour ago.
Just a second!
This is bad. We have to hurry. Celeste, do you know where this mysterious man went?
Let's see...
When he left the rec room, they headed left.
See.
If that's true, we'll be headed towards the stairs leading down to the second floor. Then he must be down there, right?
Hmm.
Second floor? That's where Kyoko is supposed to be. Huh? Speaking of which, why isn't Coco here? Sorry, I didn't have time to go look for her.
This is bad.
If a strange man did head to the second floor, Kyoko might run into him. We have to hurry. Kyoko's in danger. As soon as the words were out of my mouth, we all rushed out to the room and headed to the second floor. Hey, you two?
What?
What's going on? What's all this fuss?
What?
Yeah! You guys playing a game or something?
Does it freaking look like we're playing a game? Listen, have either of you seen Kyoko or Ifumi?
You gotta be kidding!
Nope, sure haven't! Are they on this floor? We just got here ourselves. I heard some kind of uproar, so I came running.
We came here together!
Stop talking.
No, you're just stalking me. At least I'm glad that Byakuya is being annoyed as fuck as we are with Genocide Jill, so thank god. Anyway, can you guys help look for them?
What?
Why? What happened? There's no time now. We'll explain later.
That's fine.
Well, fine. It sounds like something interesting is going on.
Okay.
Ifumi, Kyoko, if you can hear me, say something! Her voice echoed down the hall in vain.
Hmm? Oh.
Did you hear something?
Hmm.
Maybe.
Perhaps.
I think it came from the library!
Okay.
Library? Okay, let's go! We ran to the library as fast as our legs could carry us. We opened the door to the library. It hurts. Are you okay? Don't worry! Someone get an ice pack! We found Ifumi seriously injured. Are you okay? I'm glad to see you're still alive. It's super bad, though. Look at all this pink blood!
What?
How did you get hurt?
That guy hit me.
What guy?
Robo Justice. That's what I decided to call him just now.
What did you say?
What are you talking about? Okay. It's the same hammer again. What the fuck? It's a hammer. Just like the one Celeste was attacked with in the rec room, but this one is Justice Hammer 2? And on top of that, this one is actually a little bigger than the first one.
He attacked me with that hammer! He bumped me right on the head with it!
Wow.
A hammer that big? Surprised you're still okay.
I'm not okay! Just look at all this blood!
Hey.
Protein helps heal wounds, you know. Would you like some? I have never heard such a thing. Are you sure it's just you? Give us information, Ifumi. Assuming you don't have amnesia from this.
That guy was Robo Justice.
Indeed.
This Robo Justice you are referring to is... This... Is it not?
What the hell am I looking at?
What the hell am I looking at? This is the one that attacks Celeste and Ifumi. Isn't that right, Ifumi?
Yes!
That's him!
Unforgivable!
I'm sure of it! Robo Justice!
It can't be!
Robo Justice, huh?
Damn!
This just keeps getting stranger! Alright, what the fuck do you want, Monoko?
Oh.
It's him! Boohoo! A robot of justice, huh? Now things are really starting to get exciting! What kind of special move does it have? Can it fly? Can it combine?
Yeah.
No! Why is he here?
Are you okay with this?
Let us not concern ourselves with him. What we need to do now is get Ifumi to a nurse office right now, right away. Whatever else we can do, he needs to be treated as soon as possible.
Yeah!
Right, let's go.
Thanks, everyone.
Where is everyone else, though? We moved Ifumi to the nurse's office on the first floor, so we could take care of his injuries. How are you feeling, Ifumi? You want me to take a look at you? I'm okay. I think I'd stop bleeding. I'm still kinda dizzy, though.
So then?
Perhaps you should rest here in a while.
I suppose.
Yeah, good idea.
Well, then.
The rest of us should get back to looking for the mysterious assailant.
Yes, indeed.
Indeed. Before another victim appears, the Justice Hammer seems to be increasing in size. First one and now two?
So, in other words,
if there is a Justice Hammer 3, we can assume it is even bigger than the first two.
Oh!
If you got hit with anything bigger than that, you'd be dead for sure! Tell us what happened to you, Fumi. Well, I woke up earlier this morning and started looking for Alter Ego ahead of everyone else. I went to the third floor, and that's where the strange costume man attacked me. That must be what I witnessed around 7 this morning. After that, he dragged me to the library and whack, down with the hammer. That must have been 30 or 40 minutes ago. Around 7:30, in other words, we would have still been in the dining hall. Which means Hina, Sakura, and I were together, and Kyoko was still with us. So, we all have alibis. I was in the laundry room doing my laundry.
Yes!
It's black and...
What?
I'm not getting bothered commenting. Why do you know that? Isn't it obvious? Guess. Isn't it obvious? Cause I was peeking! Anyway, so that means Byakuya and Toko were together at the time. Meaning they also have alibis, or so they claim. And the only ones who don't have alibis were Celeste, for which Celeste and Fumi were attacked, are only two we haven't seen yet, Hiro and Taka. That's it, right?
Very strange.
By the way, what happened to Kyoko? I haven't seen her anywhere. Oh yeah, she was supposed to be checking the second floor, but I didn't see her up there at all. Where could she have disappeared to? She disappeared, huh? What a strange woman.
So that's it.
She might be exactly as I suspected. Hold on! Kyoko was with us during the dining hall when Celeste and Kifumi were attacked, so... I'm not talking about who attacked them. Huh?
In other words...
I'm referring to what we talked about last night. Who the mastermind spy might be. Are you saying Kyoko's working with the mastermind? That seems way too easy to decipher. I mean, come on, I know she's strange and suspicious and all that, but if that were the case, then this game just got really uncreative.
What?
Maybe it was you! Maybe you're trying to trick us into this thing. I know you're trying to make this more interesting for us, so, maybe you might have altered the truth? Is that it, Byakuya? This woman who seems almost eager to handle dead bodies hasn't even revealed her true identity.
Hey!
Save the discussion for later. Right now, we need to focus on hiding the suspicious individual.
Okay.
Yeah, if we don't hurry, there's only gonna be more victims. That might be why Kyoko and Taka and Hiro haven't shown up yet. She's right. We have to do something about that mystery man first. Don't worry about me. I'll catch up with you guys after I rest up for a bit. Understood. Take care of yourself.
Well then,
let's go. Alright, where the fuck are we searching now? So, whoever that is running around, why are they wearing that weird costume? Don't bother looking for a reason for I'm a deviant.
What to do?
So, what are we gonna do? Split up and look around? Our opponent is very dangerous. We don't know what they're capable of or even here.
What?
What's wrong? I saw the shadow! Something moving around the top of the stairs! Really? Up to the second floor then! You bastard! You won't get away from me! We all shot towards the stairs. Must be around here somewhere. Let's split up and corner him! But don't take any chances. As soon as you find him, call out and I'll come running. Okay, but what should we yell?
Just a second!
Anything! It doesn't matter!
So then...
Then is ha, okay?
What are you saying?
Ha or do ya or whatever you want, just yell loud enough so we can hear you. Do ya? I've never heard of such a reaction. Okay, whatever, just hurry up and start looking, okay? Let's go. Hey, Mr. Robot, where you hiding? If we don't know, let's go, it's a combination, yeah. Okay, we spread out, blah, 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 and let's search, okay, girls' locker room. Wait, why would I search that? Okay, why not? Alright, anyone in the stalls? I like how the first thing I search for is the fucking girl's bathroom, of all things. Okay, that strange cry. That has to be Celeste. It came from this floor above. She's on the third floor. I sprinted up to the third floor?
Everyone.
Over here, everyone. Everyone who heard the scream
just
came up
second.
Running. Celeste, what's wrong?
What?
That was a rather intense scream for someone like you. I saw him. The strange costume man. He ran off as soon as I screamed. I was blocking the stairs, so he headed down further down to the hallway and disappeared. He must be down this hall. Come on, let's go. What is it now? Oh, okay.
Huh?
Whoa, it's really true. But that doesn't matter right now! What is that noise? What was that? Came from downstairs, it must have been. He fooled me. He's in the nurse's office! This is bad. Come on, we have to go back. What about the suspect? Might have gotten blah, blah, blah. Then why don't we split into two
it's
groups?
All clear now.
I'll lead the hunting party, that seems more interesting.
So then.
Alright, very well then. Makoto and Hina, you come with me to the nurse's office. I'll leave the captured suspicious individual to Doko Sakurai and Byakuya.
So then.
We'll handle it. Go to take care of the Hifumi. Okay, you guys be careful. Good god, this is so fucking intense. What's going on? Hifumi, are you okay? Are you not
just
dead?
A second.
He's in the nurse's office, let's go! Where's the nurse's office again? Oh, is this it? This is it! Okay! We stormed to the nurse's office. What greeted us was a world of dripping crimson. Please tell me Hifumi's not dead. No! Everything was covered in pink. Not red, but okay, whatever. And in the center of all the red was... Ifumi?
No!
Ah!
What
looks like something really bad has happened. It certainly was not expecting this. I did not imagine that Ifumi would be murdered.
No way!
Murdered? You're not serious, are you? He's not really dead, is he?
A body has been discovered!
Why does it have to be him of all things? He was my
After
friend!
After a certain amount of time, which you may use however you like, the class trial will begin!
Oh, man! What the? That was the body discovery announcement. The body discovery announcement? When three or more people discover a body after a murder, that's what plays. And since we just heard it, that means... It must mean Ifumi. Someone killed him. One of us. One of us? And look at that. When Celeste said that, he pointed to something. Something on the floor. Something that had also been on the floor after the last two surprise attacks. Another hammer. Justice Hammer 3. It's even bigger than the other two. Just as I suspected. One strike from that, and you are finished. And then the killer. There can be no doubt the suspicious individual, going by what Hifumi called him, the culprit must be Robo Justice. Whoever's hiding in that costume is the one that killed Hifumi. But wait, you saw him on the third floor, right? Running back into the hall? So how did he end up in the nurse's office? You're not saying that they like teleport or something,
Are
right?
Are you okay with this?
We can figure that part out later. Right now, we have to tell the others. You're right.
So then...
Then, shall we go? Hina, stop out of it. Huh? Are you okay, Hina?
Sorry.
I'm not sure if I can move right now. I'm feeling kinda... This is a problem. We can't just leave Hina here alone. Okay then, I'll go get... Aww! I kinda wanna stay with her. Fine. You stay here with Hina. Very well. I'll leave it to you then. Okay. I'll be back soon. I tried to sound confident and upbeat, but... I still hadn't stopped trembling from what I just... been through. Everyone else is already on the third floor. I have to hurry. Oh man. This is where everyone... was chasing after this suspicious individual. Where was he headed? Celeste! What's wrong? That was a rather intense scream for someone like you. I saw him! That strange costumed man! He ran off as soon as I screamed! I was blocking the stair, so he headed further down into the hallway and disappeared. ran off, going further down the hallway. Way into the back of the hallway? That is awfully suspicious. Yeah, because all of our names are definitely not cleared right now. Our only alibi so far is from the... Door is awfully open for some reason. As far as I can tell, there's nobody here. But still, I feel some kind of presence. Yeah, I'm sure I can feel someone's presence. This presence is coming from over there in the back. I left through the doorway. When I did, I found... Another nightmare?! The second nightmare of the day was waiting there to greet me. Another murder?! Fuck! It's another murder! What the fuck?! There, in a pool of his own blood, was Taka. Dead. Fuck, really?! This is horrific. Fumi's body discovered in the nurse's office. Taka's body discovered in the equipment room. I was witness to two nightmares, one right after another. No, they weren't nightmares. This is harsh reality. Oh man, okay. The true nightmare is this reality. Reality I have faced every day, but still. Why is this happening? And for some reason she's out cold. Toko? Don't tell me, Toko too! Relax, she just passed out when she saw the blood. Blood? Alright, what? Like he said, I should just leave her alone for now. There's two murders back to back. There's bigger hammers. Is this the biggest hammer? Hammer number four? Another hammer? Now it's just this hammer four, and it's even bigger than before. Is that suspicious individual responsible for killing Taka too?
However.
But why is it just this hammer four? Huh? What do you mean? Celeste was attacked by Justice Hammer 1, and then Ifumu was hit by Justice Hammer 2. But this time it's Justice Hammer 4. What happened to number 3?
What?
What's the matter? Well, when you mentioned Justice Hammer 3, you just reminded
what?
Me. Out with it. Do you know something? Actually, Taka's not the only one that's been killed. Ifumi's dead too!
What? Hey!
Ifumi's been killed? Yeah.
I see.
Which is why you came to get us. Then we better go check it out. Of course, come on! God, how many of us are still alive right now? So Sakura, Byakuya, and I rushed out to the physics lab. But as soon as we were out of the physics lab...
Ooh.
Ah! Celeste! Aren't you supposed to be waiting in the nurse's office? Something has come up. Yeah, I heard. Ifumi is dead, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's not all, but it is gone. Huh? What's gone? It had disappeared. Disappeared? Ifumi's body had disappeared! What?!
What did you say?
What are you talking about? It disappeared? Don't be ridiculous.
Come on.
Are you serious?
What
the heck is happening here? Everyone, back to the nurse's office! Aoi was there too, wasn't she? I quickly leapt into the downstairs, nearly losing my balance. I reached the nurse's office completely out of breath. I couldn't believe my eyes. Ifumi's body was just there a few minutes earlier. Just disappeared? Me and Celeste went to the bathroom. But we were only gone for like a minute. And then when we got back... This must be the work of the culprit. They must have come and carried the body away. They must have really been enjoying this. Enjoying the sight of us standing around, frightened and confused. We're all going to die here. We're all going to die just like one of those guys. Just like those guys died.
What did you say?
I don't believe this. I don't believe a body would just disappear.
Why?
First there were two murders, and now one of the bodies has been taken. This is unnatural.
Huh?
Hold on. What do you mean, two murders?
Ina.
Taka had been killed. We found him in the equipment room. What are you doing here? Really? Right now? You shouldn't even be watching this right now. It's an M-rated game. There's blood. Get out of here. And close the door while you're there, too. See ya. What? Okay, I'll try. Why are you whispering? I'm clearly talking to you guys right now. It doesn't matter what the audience is thinking right now. Sheesh. Anyways, Taka has been killed. We found him in the equipment room.
No way!
It can't be. Taka too? It can't be.
No!
Hina.
Hina, calm down. We're all gonna die. All of us. They're gonna kill all of us. Then who might be the next tar- Then who might the next target be? Toko? Well, I wouldn't mind if Toko was dead, but did you guys really leave her body there?
What?
I completely forgot she's still unconscious in the equipment room! You fucking idiots! What the fuck?! You left her in the scene of the crime?! We didn't have a choice, she passed out and she refused to wake up.
Huh?
You could have carried her! I'm pretty sure Sagra was strong enough to lift her with one arm! What the fuck?! So, she's still unconscious?
Damn.
Wait, so you know she was still up there and said nothing? Why? That annoying little insect that clings on me whenever I go, we better be off without her.
Bastard!
You bastard! Calm down, you forget about her, didn't you? You have no right to blame me. Everyone stop fighting right now, we need to hurry back! Again, watch as Toko's body is gonna disappear just like Ifumi.
Damn.
God damn it. And of all this, Kyoko's nowhere to be seen as well. Oh shit, it's wrong one. Wrong one too, god damn it. Alright. Yeah, so, yeah. Taka's dead. To review. Ifumi's dead. We haven't seen Hiro yet. So he's certainly a culprit. And so is Kyoko. Not only that, but the way, And this might be because Byakuya is actually trying to drift us away from the true murderer. But, Celeste could be in this little bit of suspicion as well. Anyways. Oh boy. Okay. We shut out to the nurse's office and bolted stairs, heading back to the third floor. Good god, are we not tired yet? And when we got there, Toko was still there, but of course the body disappeared. Thank god you're okay. But right away I noticed, there's something very different here. It was gone. Taka's body, which should have been right there, had disappeared. Of course. This can't be happening. Are we hallucinating all this or something? No, it's not a hallucination. I know I saw it before. And what I'm saying now isn't what I saw before.
Huh?
What? Are you saying Taka disappeared too?
Stop talking.
Stop saying disappear. It didn't just vanish out of thin air. Obviously, whoever did this has hidden the body. But why would they do that? I couldn't possibly begin to imagine.
Okay.
Anyway, our costumed suspect is clearly continuing his crime spree.
Huh?
We gotta hurry and catch him before he kills all of us!
Not possible.
Oh, I don't think you have to worry about that.
Huh?
Think about it. Who could possibly be responsible for killing and hiding these dead bodies? When Ifumi's death... When Ifumi's death cry went up, everyone here was together on the third floor.
It is so.
After that, we split up into two groups. And now this time, you all came up here as a group from the nurse's office. In other words, the only ones who could have done this are Hiro and Kyoko, who are still missing. Hold on a second. Kyoko has an alibi for when Celeste and Ifumi were attacked. There's no question that she was in the dining hall with us. You seem very adamant about defending her. Perhaps you are- No! If there's anyone I'm in love with, it's fucking Aoi! Kirikiri, she's more like a friend. I can't believe I'm saying this though, but I'm more friend-zoning her, if anything. It's Aoi that I want to get her pants on. That's not at all. Well, anyway, Yes, I do accept Kyoko's alibi.
Let's see.
Which means the suspicious individual we're looking for can be none other than Hiro. Which further means there will be no murders. The regulations are very clear about that. Oh, that's right. There's only a rule that says you can only kill a maximum of 2 people.
That's right.
As long as the rule is in place, there will not be any, there will not be a third murder. If they were to break that rule...
Shing!
Aye, Mincia! Mincia, without a second thought! Mincia, grind ya, turn ya into paste! By the way, did you know that fish paste also refers to shellfish, like shrimp or crabs? Oh, damn it, dude. Anyways, indeed.
Let's see.
So, since 2 people have been killed, there is no possibility for any more. Unless there's 2 murderers. If there are 2 murderers, then I'm assuming 2 of us will be dead even further if we continue
perhaps
to elaborate this. You knew that from the beginning, didn't you, Byakuya? Which means you knew Toko was never in danger. I still meant it when I said we'd better be off without her, though.
In other words.
You know, I agree with you there, dude. I have no objection to that. Anyways, with that in mind, we can now relax and search for the 2 missing bodies. 2 missing bodies. 2 people have been killed and their bodies have been hidden. The only one without an alibi, and the only one who could have done it is... Hiro. But is he really the killer? And what about Kyoko? If she's not involved in this case, where'd she go?
What?
Hey, Makoto, what's the matter? Huh? Oh, it's nothing. Whatever, we need to find those bodies in our little narrative here. We can't move... we can't move forward.
So then...
Very well. Then let us split up and begin searching.
But...
There's no need to be afraid. No more murders will take place during the class.
I mean...
I know that. I mean, I think I do, but...
You know.
You're still... If you're still nervous, I'll come with you. Okay, thank you. No need to thank me. Let's get moving. Yell out if you find anything. Byakuya left the equipment room, followed by the others. Have to try and find the 2 missing bodies. And we will do that in the next recording session of Danganronpa. Oh boy, has been a long, long day, ladies and gentlemen. But I think... No, we should probably save it in a new save file, just in case this save file gets corrupted or something. Anyway, so, that was... our 5th recording session of Danganronpa. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the future of my Let's Plays. This is Basinger, signing out. And by the time we continue through this war, we'll find the missing bodies, and we'll find who else murdered our 2 best... Well, I wouldn't say Taka would be our best friend, but he could have been our friend. Oh, well, whatever. See you guys then. And shit. Yeah.